to me and Jim Ball. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Making sure the broadcast is working. Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. We're just testing the audio to see if it works. We're just checking the audio of the microphone. 1, 2, 3. We're just testing. Welcome back to Video Gamers Oasis on Twitch. I'm your host, Jeremy. And we're back again on Video Gamers Away Sales Twitch for another study, and as well as a Patrick application of this software I have had for a long time. Teach yourself to play guitar. CD-ROM, deluxe edition. We've been watching some videos on some basic chords and strings, introduction to different chords and strings. We previously were looking at, let's see here, we were looking at notes on the fifth string, high A, the high A string. Now we've moved on to notes on the sixth string, E. So we're going to get started again. I want to make it clear, I'm not really playing any music right now. I'm not actually practicing some guitar. I performed some music for my family yesterday. So I know how to play guitar, but I want to go through all these videos very quickly so I can digitally broadcast myself watching these videos and use them for myself for my studies. And I'm going to be, after I finish the software, I'm going to be doing a weekly practice session with guitar on Twitch. That's one of the plans that I'm going to set in motion. So follow me if you haven't already. Click the follow button on Twitch. Also subscribe to Video Gamers Oasis YouTube channel. This specific type of video, these series of videos will be uploaded on my Twitch YouTube channel. It's a VOD channel, Video Gamers Oasis VOD channel. So there's a link in the description where you can subscribe to that channel for all my videos on Twitch. Uploaded there, and I'll be doing Minecraft in the future again, so make sure to subscribe to my VGO Craft Toots, which is a totally different channel than this one. It's all Minecraft. So let's get on with the playing of we're going to be doing another lesson, make sure the audio is there. Okay, good. So let's learn about notes on the sixth string, E.
The sixth string, E, is the thickest string and located closest to the ceiling. When the E string is played open, it sounds the note E and looks like this on the staff. When the E string is played with the first finger on the first fret, it sounds the note F and looks like this on the staff. When the E string is played with the third finger on the third fret, it sounds the note G and looks like this on the staff. To get used to the notes we just learned, go on to the next example, and then go ahead to the next page to review all the notes we've just covered.
Okay, so just so I can absorb all this information, I'm going to take a snapshot.
The sixth string, E, is the thickest string and located closest to the ceiling. When the E string is played open, it sounds the note E and looks like this on the staff.
So we'll take a snapshot of this. Notes on the sixth string E. Save this. Notes on the sixth string E. Notes on the sixth string E. And we'll save this as new notes. Not new nights, but new notes. And we'll sing that as one. We'll save that.
E string is played with the first finger on the first fret, it sounds the note F and looks like this on the staff.
So it looks like an F. Okay, so I'll just scan that one here. We'll save that as new notes two. Okay.
String is played with the third finger on the third fret, it sounds the note G and looks like this on the staff.
G. So we'll snag that one as well. Very good.
To get used to the notes we just learned, go on to the next example, and then go ahead to the next page to review all the notes we've just covered.
Okay, now we can move on. Next segment of the lesson. Notes on the sixth string E, in the natural scale. So what I'm going to do, this is a small little picture. It's a nice picture of this, the bass and the solo strings, but it's very tiny, so I'm going to snapshot this. And I'm going to save this as the natural scale under images, the natural scale. Save that as notes on the sixth string E, the natural scale. Go to Photoshop to edit the photo. I'm going to make a larger version of this. So we'll close that up. We don't need that image right now. So we're going to go to videos, teach yourself guitar. Sixth string E, close that up and we'll make a nice little edited version. And we'll close, copy this, copy and paste, make a duplicate. Copy and paste. And then what we'll do is we'll just delete anything excess, make it white, okay? So we will edit free form, a larger version of that. And what we'll do is we'll crop it a bit, save it, and we'll resave it as a JPEG, as before, just edited version. And And what we'll do is we'll open it up again, make sure it looks good. Yeah, that's what I call an edited version of the bass and soul strings note paper. It's really, really good, really good. So that looks a lot better. E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. Bass string, 6th string, 0, 1, 2, 3. 5th string, 0, 2, 3. 4th string, 0, 2, 3. 3rd string, 0, 2. 2nd string, 0, 1, 3. And 1st string, 0, 1, 3, 5. Those are the solo strings, and these are the bass strings. 6, 2, 4 is bass strings. 3, 2, 1 is solo strings. Pretty straightforward there. Let's move that on to the next segment. Silver threads among the gold. Let's get our video capture device. So we're going to capture this for later. We're going to use this video for our studies in the future because I want to be a really good guitar player on my own time. I don't like to be rushed. That's one of the reasons why I'm not doing these videos and practicing guitar right away. As soon as I get them, I practice on my own time and I learn better when I'm not rushed. Maybe that's different for you, but I prefer to relax and enjoy guitar and not feel pressured. So let's get our microphone set up and start the recording. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Silver threads among the gold. Has a hip hop beat to it, and a little bit of DJ records scratching. Beautiful. Let's close this up, and we will use this video for later study. I'm going to save this, but first I'm going to delete any excess audio that's superfluous. It's good. Okay, so let's make sure I save it properly. Silver threads among the gold. So we're going to save this under Teach Yourself, Play Guitar, and we'll call this what is this again? Notes on the 6th string E. Notes on the 6th string E. And we will save this as silver threads among the gold. Call this a video, music video. Music video lesson. Save it. It's good. So let's save it and export it. Under video, Teach Yourself, Play Guitar, under video section. We'll save that. And we'll proceed with our lesson after this. Did I accidentally close the software? That was silly. Okay, open up the game again. Open it up. Open up at notes on the sixth string E.
The sixth string E is the thickest string and located closest to the finger on the first fret. It sounds the.
All right, we already did silver threads among the gold. Let's move on.
Tempo signs indicate how fast or slow to play. The three principal tempo signs are andante, which means slow,
andante.
Moderato, which means moderately, and allegro, which means fast. Click on the tempo signs below to hear examples of each.
Okay, actually click on it? Okay, good. That's something I didn't really know before, but now I do. So let's save this as notes on the sixth string E. And we will save this right here. And we'll save this as tempo signs. And we'll open up that in Photoshop. And we'll open this up in Photoshop like this. And we will proceed. Pretty good. It's good. Okay. Let's get this photograph. We don't need this video playing in the, there's no video actual playing. Okay. So save that again. There we go. Andante, moderato, and allegro. Let's do a video session just to get it in my head properly. So we'll save this, new file. Let's start a new recording session. Let's make it really cropped this time, right here. We'll start again in 3, 2, 1. Start the video again.
Tempo signs indicate how fast or slow to play. The three principal tempo signs are andante, which means slow, moderato, which means moderately, and allegro, which means fast. Click on the tempo signs below to hear examples of each.
Okay, so let's go through each individual one. Andante, slow. Let's go to the moderato now, moderately. And finally, allegro, fast. Save that, and we will Let's see if I can keep the video with the narration this time. Tempo signs. Save this under videos. Notes on the sixth string E, and we'll save this as tempo signs. Tempo signs. Instructional video. Start the video again.
Tempo signs indicate how fast or slow.
So let's go through each individual one. Andante, slow. Okay, it's good. I just want to crop out some of that excess junk on my video. Good. So we'll delete that part. Andante, slow. I'll delete that. And we'll put a part here. Vibrato now, moderately. And finally, allegro. And finally, allegro. Finally, allegro fast. There you have it. So let's crop that and we will save it.
To hear examples of each.
Okay, so let's go through each individual one. Andante, slow. Let's save this all and we'll convert it to a video. Under videos, tempo signs, instructional video. Start the video again.
Tempo signs indicate how fast or slow to play.
Andante, slow. Oh, it's good. All right, we'll save that and move on to a new file. And we'll go on to, what is the next session? After tempo signs, we have notes on the third, on the sixth string E, three tempo rock. Let's get the video recording session started. This time we'll make it magnified. Save and start the recording in 3, 2, 1. Three tempo rock. Tempo rock is completed. Excellent. So make that a recording completed. And we'll go over to our session here, recording session. It's good. So we'll save this as video session will be called. Three tempo rock. Three tempo rock. We'll save that as a music video lesson. Export that. Proceed with the video recording. Tempo rock is complete. Moving on. Okay. So now we can go to the next segment. Notes on the sixth string E. Plaisir d'amore. So let's get the recording out. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Start the recording playing. There you have Plaisir d'amour. We will stop the recording. Save this. Okay. We'll save this as Plaisir d'amour. Save that. Plaisir d'amour. And make sure that we have the correct spelling. It's amour with the A-O-U-R. Video lesson. Okay, save that. And we'll export that. Proceed with the exporting of our video lesson. Good. So move on to the next one. Next video. Let's go on to the next one. Now we've moved on to a whole new lesson. Bass chord accompaniments.
A popular way of playing chord accompaniments in 4/4 time.
Example number one. So we'll take a little break, folks, and we will continue this another day. So let's open this up and... And there you have it, folks. That was our lesson. We were learning about another video lesson of sixth string E, I believe. Making sure I got that correct. Notes on the sixth string E, yes. So thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to Video Gamers Oasis VOD channel. This video will be uploaded on that channel. Send some likes, send some love, subscribe. For more videos, more content. Thanks for watching. We will continue this lesson of the software. Teach yourself to play guitar, Deluxe Edition, another day. So have a great week, and don't give up playing guitar. It's a great musical instrument to express your feelings and to sharpen your math skills and your thought processing skills. It's so good to learn a musical instrument. For me personally, has been a great way for me to have more depth in my life and more dimension of enjoyment that I haven't experienced before. To be able to actually perform music for yourself, for your own enjoyment. And when you go to parties, you'll be able to entertain your friends. So I highly recommend you learn to play the guitar using this software. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.